One love. Love two.
Head to head between the two men stands at 2-1 to Felix. But the last time they played was at the Champions Incheon. Calderano won in straight games.
3-1.
Well, the net's being kind to the Brazilian. That's a couple of net calls already that have left Lebrun without any chance whatsoever.
4-1.
Magnificent backhand from the South American.
Ooh, a counter right back into the crossover. It was a very spinny ball. Calderano lifted the half long. Backhand, they're so, you know, similar in terms of level, but I'd say Calderano has the stronger forehand.
Oh, 4.
Felix barely ever goes back. Doesn't need to, because of how he can dominate up to the table.
Already, this promises to be a terrific final, doesn't it? We only had about a couple of minutes, but hugely entertaining. And close, just how we like it. What about a 15-13 in the seventh, one way or the other?
See if you press her answer, Trevor.
4-5.
There's never been a decider between the two. Why not today? Closest game they had was when Felix beat him in Goa, 4-2. Calderano had a game point or two to go 3-0 up in that final.
5-5.
Really are the two strongest players right now outside of the Chinese team.
5-7.
Clever serve from Calderano. He's a high toss server. But Lebrun just has his face forward, focusing on the point of contact.
7-7.
But if you receive, it's just a tad bit too loose. I mean, that's not even a long one from Lebrun. Calderano swoops in, so often with a point ender.
Clearly got supporters of both men in the hall.
8-8.
Some compensation there for Felix, who obviously missed a serve. Good push. No other number 5.
Well, it's just as close as we thought and we hoped it would be, certainly early on here. And hold their nerve the better business end of this opening game.
9-9. 9, 10.
So first game point goes to the Brazilian. Oh. Albeit on the LeBron serve. And he's got it though, 11-9. And Calderano strikes first here.
Second game, LeBron to serve, level. One.
Wonderful spot there from Calderano with this flick.
Scream of anguish from the Frenchman. Such high standards for both men do. Say that Calderano's a particularly slow player, but compared to LeBron, he's a tortoise. The Frenchman gets it back into play so quickly.
Well, Calderano's a harder hitter. He goes for broke more than LeBron. Felix just barely misses and places the ball out with great spin. It's funny because even though he plays at a higher tempo, he plays the longer game, Felix.
Just feel that when you play him, he gets on with it so quickly as his opponent, and you never feel completely settled when you're receiving serve.
You can't be settled because you don't know what's going to come, and that's testament to the deception at the pro level. I think Felix is getting a little bit desperate here, and Calderano's keeping his cool. LeBron's trying to win a point straight away and has lost a bit of that deception in doing so.
6-4.
And ours from this one.
Such a low trajectory. Just literally kissed the table, didn't it?
I thought you'd taken it a bit too late, Calderano. Yeah.
4-8.
Well, forehand, backhand, all coming the same to him at the moment. LeBron must feel like he's one of those ducks in a fairground shooting range. Coming at him from all angles.
Well, that's an escape for Calderano. Bit of fortune changed the fate of that point. But it hasn't been that's made the difference.
So very quickly, Calderano has 5 points for a 2-love lead. Off to an absolute flyer. 11-5.
180 more points for winning it than you do losing in the final. And, you know, the very top of the tree in the world, you know, some of the top Chinese may have points that are about to expire. So who knows? One of these two could end up overtaking a couple of them.
Now, if you're a LeBron fan, You might have some semi-cheery news.
It looks like Calderano's outmanning him at the moment. It's alpha mentality of the Brazilian. And Felix is capitulating. This timeout doesn't seem to have helped.
No. And I want to turn to now. He's on the board. Sounds rather heartless to say it, but from Calderano's point of view, when you've got your foot on the other guy's throat, metaphorically, you need to keep it there. Can't give him any encouragement. Try and get back into a match where he's been dominated thus far. And to say that, LeBron comes from 4-0 down to be just the point behind now. How about that? Delayed reaction to the timeout, Fraser.
He could say that from where we're sat, but this is a great response from Felix. So it's back with Calderano. Minifio Nathaniel Malone there, and you know, the coaching Felix LeBron. You can't imagine he went too hard on the tactics when Felix was losing. Felix knows how to win this match. Just a case for me of how calm he is.
Well, that's 6 points on the spin.
Has Calderano begun to think about that? Final in goer, or is this just testament to LeBron's improvement? Hard to say, isn't it?
Yeah. I think it would be at the back of Calderon's mind. Like Calderano's mind, I think.
7-4.
Because you don't forget something like that easily.
Well, for me, his mentality really has improved. I mean, he's always been such a hard worker, like an unbelievably hard worker. But in Chongqing, from 2-0 down against Ovtcharov to come back against, you know, the man who beat him in the Olympics, to beat Liang Jingquin, who came back to a decider after he was 2-0 up, and then have that mental fortitude to win the decider. He looks better mentally, Calderano, now. He had a couple of tough losses, you know, in 2021. Two Ovtcharov in the Olympic quarterfinal. Two Liang Jingquin from 3-0 up in Houston. It feels like he's laid a few of his ghosts to rest.
6-7.
And if he hadn't have managed to achieve that, then for me, I would have been going harder on the LeBron button than I am today.
Tuck that backhand away very nicely. Well, it's been a bizarre third game so far. Upshot being that we're all level again. Turns the heat up again. Here are three game points, rather, for a 3-love lead for the Brazilian. Remember, he led 4-love in this game, trailed 6-4. Topsy-turvy, doesn't cover it. Well, absolutely superb towards the end of that game. And it's 11-7, and it's 3-love. So can LeBron rouse himself, get back into this match somehow? Just needs a foothold. Because he is the kind of player that we know he's capable of running up, creating clusters.
I think this is the first time I've seen Félix Lebrun 3-0 down in a best of seven. Let's see how he does.
One, two.
Not used to being in this situation. You know, won his previous and only two finals.
Two,
but
two.
Calderano just has that grizzled aura, persona.
Two,
and he is striking the ball when the iron's hot. He is meeting it at exactly the right points. Scary power, and
four, two.
Lebrun is absolutely miffed here. He's really resenting this situation, and he's got to relax. He's just got to relax. And I know that's easier said than done, but, you know, you're facing your opponent. You don't want to be facing yourself as well.
Five,
yes. Two. Becoming something of a humbling experience, this. And hugely unexpected, to be honest. Not so much that Calderano looks like he might take down this title, but just the manner of it, the margin of it.
Well, it was just so surprising how he beat him in Incheon. In the quarterfinals, 3-0. The switch went in Calderano's mind, I think, after that Goa final, and it hasn't been the same since.
Crowd doing their absolute best to raise his spirits. And he's got himself back on terms from 5-2 down. Just confirmed that LeBron has picked up a yellow card for a little bit of petulance.
Five,
another streak here.
Well, that's what I was saying earlier. I mean, we know he's capable of doing it. Saw it in the last game. He won 6 points in a row. Still couldn't win the game.
Six, six.
He's not having too many issues with the kind of round shovel action of Felix's serve. This one's a pendulum. Maybe another right choice to play the backhand from there from Calderano. His backhand is so good. I mean, we've seen him do 3-point forehand exercise with the backhand in training.
Yeah.
Oh.
Oh, that's fantastic. A little cheeky, and brilliantly done. Now then, got himself in front. Can he take advantage here and extend this final?
Devastating power. Make it or break it for LeBron.
Eight, nine.
That backhand's a thing of beauty, isn't it? Calderano's absolutely nails it. 9 times out of 10, but LeBrun comes back at him.
With the RPB snaps through there.
So Calderano 2 points away from this title. LeBrun 2 points away from at least getting a foothold in this final.
Ten, nine.
And now an opportunity for Hugo Calderano to take down this title. Championship point.
Thank you.
Honestly did not see a final as one-sided as this coming after everything we've witnessed this week. But you just can't do anything other than congratulate Hugo Calderano. Fraser, he's been brilliant tonight.
He's been magnificent.